Hi viewers, we are studying about circuits and we are designing our own circuits in electronics. So we don't know that our circuit is working or not. So for that purpose, a software is developed, that is Proteus. Using this Proteus, we can simulate our own circuits in this Proteus software, and we can verify that it's working or not. So if it is not work, we can change our circuit and another time simulate it. So if the software is not available, first we and all what we do, we will buy a hardware and we will test it. So if the test is failed, the whole circuit is failed. So our circuit is failure. So it's a waste of money. For that purpose, we can use our Proteus software. So using this software, we can simulate our own circuits. So in this video, what we're going to see is how to use simulation by Proteus software. The home page of the Proteus design suite is 8.0. This is our main page. So our Proteus provides us a two method, that is using ISIS you can develop your schematic, and using ARES you can develop the PCB design. So first we want to schemat our design, so go to ISIS. So our dashboard is this is our dashboard. Here we can keep our components and simulate it. So we can select our component using this component icon, and it will provide a pick and library. So using pick, you can select the keyword. Using keyword also you can pick our components, or else all the categories are available. So from this you can also search our desirable component. So now I'm going to give a simple simple circuit, that is LED glowing. For that I need a LED, and its color is green. So this is our LED, and we can double click it, it will come to this shortcut board. And I want a resistor, so I will give RES is a short form of a resistor, so I will give a resistor. And that's all our components. Now we want to place our components, so I select the LED and click it, double click it, it will I'll zoom and show. So now I kept our LED, so right clicking it, we can change the direction of the LED. So I will change the direction. I want to keep a resistor, so click the resistor and keep it, and click on the end, the wire will come, so you can join it. Now you want to give a power and a ground, so for that you go into terminal mode icon. So here we'll display the power and ground, so select the power and keep it, double click it and join to it. Now you want to give the watt volt supply, you want to give, so give supply as plus 5 volt plus 5 volt and click enter. Next we want to give a ground, so give a ground and join it. So the default they will give a resistance as 10k. Now we want to change it to our purpose. So for LED I will give 220 ohm, so just click 220 and click OK. So that's all our circuit. Now we want to simulate it. For simulation they has a buttons, that is pass play button, stop button and pass button. So now I give a play button. See, our circuit is working. So now my circuit is working, so that I can develop another hardware and I will display it. Now I will explain these icons. This icon is used for that arrow mark, and this is for component selecting, and this is for our ports, power ports and ground ports. This is for our power supply, ground and bus, output and input. And this is all another graph modes and active, this one all. So from using this you can give a DC generator, sine wave and another files are, you can pulse wave, all you can generate it. And this is a probe, so our we will run a multimeter. So in real time we will check in multimeter. In simulation also there is a voltage probe and current probe and tape. Using this you can check the current also and voltage also. So another one thing I will miss, so you cannot change while running. So you want to change anything, you want to stop it and you can change it. So now I can keep this at join it and play it, it will display the voltage of our circuit to LED. Next, this are all the meters. What are the instruments we are available? That is oscilloscope, logic analyzer, counter timing. This virtual terminal is used for our Arduino. We can use for our serial communication. That is serial monitor as this virtual terminal. That SPI debugger, I2C debugger, signal generator also is available. Pattern generator and voltmeter, AC voltmeter, DC voltmeter also, and DC ammeter and AC ammeter also available. That's all. These are all the other shapes, and that's not a purpose. Next, I will show you how to simulate the Arduino in our Proteus software. So, before that, you want to download the Arduino library from Google. So now I already download the library and select it, copy it, go to Windows C drive. And inside that, if it is program data is not view, so go to view menu and click hidden items. So I will give the hidden items tick box, you will see the program data, and go inside, select lab center and electronics. So you will see the Proteus 8 professional. Inside that there is a library folder, click it inside and paste it. So I paste that all the library. So next we will come to our software. Now we can check the Arduino libraries add or not. So go to pick and give the name as Arduino. So these are our libraries added. So click it and click OK. So our Arduino is added. So place it in our dashboard. So our Arduino is placed. Now I am going to give a blink circuit using Arduino. How we are going to simulate in this Proteus. So I add a resistor and a LED. So I will change the direction. Right click and change it. So connect to 13th pin. So as the I will not this 13th pin in your program, you are going to give in pin as give here and ground it. Now we go into our Arduino software. To simulate Arduino in Proteus, you want a hex file. To generate a hex file, you want to give a compilation tick box in a file menu. So for that, you go to file menu, go to preferences. Inside that, you want to click the checkbox, this compilation. It's default, it will uncheck. You go and check it and give OK. So our compilation is started. So now we want to give a program. So I will go to file, examples. In basics, I will give a blink program. So our blink program is opened. So now we want to compile it. So give compile. So our compilation is started in. So in before that, you will not see the compilation. These are all the compilations. You cannot see it while giving a checkbox as compilation. You can see all the compilation done by the compiler. So from this, we can see the hex file also and copy and paste. So now I will show you how it is done. So now we can view it. So I will expand this bar and we search for this hex file, dot hex file. So this move, see, this is the dot hex file for our Proteus. So click it and select this hex file till this C drive. So select this file and copy it by clicking Ctrl C. Now open the Proteus. You should not close the Arduino software also. So the simultaneously the two software should run, then only it will simulate. So now open the Proteus and double click this Arduino board. This menu, this dialog box will appear. So in program files box, keep the cursor and give Ctrl V, paste. paste this hex file in here and click OK. So now our hex file is pasted. So you should not close this Arduino file also. So now you can run this program. Wait for some time. Sorry, I mistake it. I not changed this 10k as 220 ohm. Now I changed this 220 ohm. I got simulated. So see, our program is running in a Proteus in blink and 1 second for delay. See, using this you can simulate the Arduino also in our Proteus. So using this software, you can use all the Arduino programs in this simulation way. So now my circuit is working. So now I can buy a Arduino board and I can develop it. So that's all our example circuit. So you can build your own circuit using this Proteus software. So if any library is needed for this software, you can download it from the Google, and you can, I showed already how to paste the Arduino library in Proteus. Likewise, you can paste your own library and build the Proteus circuit. So that's all our circuit. Thank you.